using the Laplace transform to solve the initial value problem y prime plus y equals e to the negative 3t cosine 2t, and you are given the condition that is y 0 equals 0. So first of all, we are going to use the transform of a derivative theorem on the left side. So following the theorem, we have for y prime, we have s to the first times capital y of s. So always start with s to the derivative. Always start with s to the power of the derivative times capital y of s, and then subtract out to until you reach s to the 0 minus s. So you have s to the first minus s to the 0 times y of 0. And for this one, it doesn't have any derivative, so you want to have s to the 0 times capital y of s. And on this side, the Laplace transform of this. So to find the Laplace transform of this, you are going to use the translation on the s-axis theorem. So the translation on the s-axis theorem says that, so we're gonna ignore this first. So the Laplace transform of cosine 2t is equal to s over s squared plus 4, right? And for this one, the translation, the a is equal to negative 3, so it's gonna shift to the right, 3. So the shift is 3, so we have s plus 3 squared on top and the bottom, okay? Now let's take a look at the capital Y of s's. Factor out capital Y of s. Then we have s plus 1 times capital Y of s is equal to s plus 3 over s plus 3 squared plus 4. And y of 0 equals 0, so this goes away. Now I'm going to divide both sides by s plus 1 to get capital Y of s along. Okay, so on the left side I have capital Y of s, and on the right side I have s plus 3 over s plus 1 times s plus 3 squared plus 4. So we can notify the inverse Laplace transform of this directly. For this one, I'm going to use partial fraction decomposition method to find its fractions. So let me work inside here. And let's rewrite it. So this equals a over s plus 1 plus bs plus c over s plus 3 squared plus 4. So for this one, it has only a constant, but for this one has bs plus c. The reason is because you have irreducible quadratic. So you have to account for every possibility, account for every s that has a power lower than this, which means that we have s to the first and s to the 0. So b could be 0. That means then we have only constant on top, but it could be a non-zero number. So we have to account for every possibility. Now multiply both sides by the LCD, which is all everything on the denominator. Then I get s plus 3 equals a times s plus 3 squared plus 4 plus bs plus c times s plus 1. And let's take a look at the limit as s approaches negative 1. On the left side, I get 2 on the right side, since the reason why I take a limit of s approach negative 1 is because it helps me to eliminate this, right? So I have only this one. I can let s equal 1 because you will have problem as you divide by 0. Now for this one, looking when I have 2 squared, which is 4, 4 plus 4 is 8a. Then my a is equal to 1/4. Now there's no more factors that we can take a limit, so we have to use the equating coefficient. Let's take a look at the leading coefficient of s squared, which is the highest exponent. On the left side I have 0, on the right side I have a plus b. So I know, since I know a, which is 1/4, then b has to be negative 1/4. Let's take a look at the leading coefficient of s to the 0. You can go down in order as s to the second, s to the first, s to the 0. But I have only one term left, which is c. So I like to work with a constant. That's why I let s. That's why I take a look at the leading coefficient of s to the 0. On the left side, I have 3. On the right side, I have just 4a plus c. So I know a, which is 1/4. So this, 1/4, let's see. So c equals 2. Made a mistake here. So when you multiply this out, you want to have s squared. Let me write it up here, s squared plus 6s plus 9. Okay, and then 9 plus 4, which is 13. So I actually have 13a plus c. So a is 1/4, so plug it in 5c. 13 over c, 3 minus 13 over c. Then I get c equals negative 1/4. Okay? Now I'm going to plug this back in here. So back to this one. I have, so this is the same as this, the summation of these. So a over s plus 1 and a is equal to 1/4 plus b over s plus 3 squared plus 4. So I'm going to break this down into two fractions, bs over this and cs over this. So bs and b is equal to negative 1/4, so I have negative 1/4 s over this plus c over this again, and c is equal to negative 1/4. Okay? Now we are going to take the we are going to apply the error inverse on both sides. But before I do that, I'm going to make this matches the form cosine, which means we have s plus 3 on top and the bottom. So let me do it down here. One more step. Just rewrite this 1/4 over s plus 1 plus, okay, for this one, to match the form, we need to have s plus 3 on top, right? Because this is a shift translation on the s-axis. So I have, so this matches the form what we need for the translation of cosine. But initially it just has negative 1/4s, right? So when I make this, I have to fix it. So I add 3 and then the leading coefficient is negative 1/4, so multiply it more, distribute this out, I have negative 3/4. So it's gonna be 0 if I add 3/4, right? So negative 3/4 plus 3/4, which is 0, then I have only negative 1/4s. And rewrite this. Now you are going to break this out into two fractions. I can add the steps here. Normally I would not do this because it's just put them together. So break this out, I have 3/4 over this, and you notice we have the same denominator, so I'm going to combine this and this together. So 3/4 minus 1/4, which gives me 2/4, and that is 1/2. So now I'm going to apply the error inverse on both sides. So on the left side, I have y of t, and on the right side, factor out 1/4. When factor out 1/4, I have an error inverse of 1 over s plus 1 is e to the negative t. Factor out negative 1/4, and error inverse of this is equal to cos2t times e to the negative 3t. Don't forget the translation. On the x-axis, the shift is 3. Plus, so to match the form, let me factor out 1/4. Let me write the 2 down here. So I have 1/4 times 2. Okay, so this matches the formula of psi2t. Okay, and the shift is e to the negative 3t. Okay, so just ignore this. So you have 2 over square plus 2, that is psi2t, and the shift is 3, so you have e to the negative 3t. So this is the formula by using the translation on the x-axis theorem. You will get this. So this is your final answer eventually. That's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.